Hello dear students, welcome back to this channel under the banner of the Zoological Society of Assam for the benefit of the students, particularly regarding the environmental studies. Myself, Dr. Brishti Datta from Dergaon Komal Dwara College, Dergaon. Today, I am going to discuss a topic from the CBCS syllabus of environmental studies under the unit 2, that is ecosystem. The topic is river ecosystem. Hope this discussion will be helpful for you. Let us go for the discussion. Learning outcomes. After going through the discussion, we are coming to know about the following points. What are rivers or river ecosystem? Structure of rivers and river ecosystem, influencing factors or components of river ecosystem, and functional aspects of river ecosystem. Now let us go for the whole discussion. What are rivers? A river is a large natural course of flowing water obtained from precipitation. Actually, on the basis of the types of habitats, rivers are flowing water habitat or water bodies. A river is a large natural course of flowing water derived from precipitation. It occurs as a result of moving down of surface water along the slope due to the action of gravity. Every major river must have a place of origin in the upstream side, which is termed as headwater, and a point of confluence with the sea or water body at the downstream end. Thus, river water is always on move. A river is a powerful geological agent, as it has the capacity to erode, transport and deposit the sediments, that is river alluvium. As shown in the figure, rivers may be perennial, has continuous flow of water throughout the year, or intermittent, can be termed as intermittent streams, where water flow is seasonal, or may be ephemeral or ephemeral streams, the flow is occasional. Now let us come to the structure of river ecosystem. While discussing this point, we must say the rivers split into three parts longitudinally: upper course, middle course and lower course. As shown in the second figure, upper course is closer to the source, the land is high and mountainous, and the river has a steep gradient with fast flowing water. Middle course, where the river starts to slow down, and it can take up most of the river, as one might find here certain floodplains, meanders, oxbow lakes, etc. Certain tributaries may also join at this point. The lower course is the lowest course of a river and it approaches the sea. River usually has a wide smooth channel and water moves at its slowest, and one might find here large floodplains, estuary, deltas, etc. Then you can see in the figure the river mouth, which is the confluence of the river and approaches towards the ocean. Now, river ecosystem is also influenced by various biotic and abiotic factors. Abiotic factors mainly include physical and chemical factors. Physical factors are slope, certain substrate, flow velocity of water, turbidity, depth of river, light penetration and temperature. On the other hand, chemical factors include dissolved oxygen, pH, alkalinity and free carbon dioxide, which are very important for the survival of the river organisms. Now students, let us come to the biotic factors. Producers, the chief producers that remain permanently attached to a firm substrate are attached green algae such as cladophora, diatoms and sometimes aquatic mosses, etc. The rooted plants are found in the areas of reduced water current where sediment is found. Free floating plants are unable to maintain large population in fast flowing water, therefore present in large number in slow moving rivers. The consumers show certain features or characteristics such as presence of hooks and suckers, sticky undersurface so as for attachment to a firm substrate, streamlined bodies, flattened bodies, etc. Varieties of zooplanktons, benthic fauna or organisms like fresh caddisfly larvae, echinodermal larvae, snails, flatworms, stonefly, mayfly nymphs, small fish act as primary consumers. Various types of fishes and freshwater crabs act as secondary consumers. And large fishes and river turtle act as tertiary consumers. Some trees and plants act as shades for other life and filter pollutants and extract trace metals from the sediments. Predator-prey relationship can be seen or more along the river. The decomposers are detritivorous, consuming food from dead bodies of producers and consumers, particularly bacteria and fungi living on the bottom of the river. Here, I must mention this, that the varieties of local and migratory birds, snakes, frogs, etc. come to the river for drinking water, fishing, bathing, etc. can also be included within the river ecosystem. Functional aspects of river ecosystem reflects how the biotic components are related to each other. The biotic components in a river ecosystem are related to each other via food chain and foodway. Now, let us discuss about food chain and foodway. For example, in a river ecosystem, the bottom vegetation like algae, mosses, or macrophytes act as producers and they are consumed by some benthic invertebrates like bottom dwelling organisms like mayfly, shrimps or snails act as primary consumers. They are consumed by planktivorous fishes which act as secondary consumers, and large fishes or turtle consume primary and secondary consumers and act as tertiary consumers. And in turn, they are consumed by the predatory birds like eagle, kingfisher, falcon, which act as quaternary consumers. Thus, it is an example of food chain, which is a series of organisms by the process of eating and being eaten. Planktivorous fish may be consumed by predatory birds. Again, phytoplanktons are consumed by herbivorous zooplankton, that is primary consumers, which is in turn consumed by either planktivorous fish or benthic invertebrates. Phytoplankton may be consumed by planktivorous fish or benthic invertebrates. In this way, due to the feeding habits of the organisms in a river ecosystem, various food chains are interconnected to produce a network called food web. In this way, via the food chain and food web, the various levels of organisms from producers and various levels of consumers, they are interconnected to each other. These are the suggested readings. If this discussion was helpful for you, or if you think that this presentation will help you, then please like and subscribe our channel. If you have any query, then please drop your queries in the given ID. Thank you.